Hi, girls.
Hi, girls.
Hi, girls.
Hi guys, so today I am going to be doing a jumbo braid ponytail tutorial. I love this hairstyle because it's super seasonal. You can wear it whenever. It's so low maintenance, low effort, and it's super quick and easy and affordable. So for all my ladies out there that want to be cute on a budget, I got you. So right now I have my hair straightened. Now you can do this style with your hair wet, with it curly. It just depends on like your preference and what works best for your hair. I know for my hair, I feel like it lays better and it looks smoother when it's straightened. I have my flat iron on right now, and this is by ISO. I love this flat iron. This is the Sunshine Girl one, and this was only $80, I believe. So I'm just gonna straighten out my edges, get my little kitchens in the back, honey, so it could just lay flat and so cute. So that is all straightened out. I am going to be doing this hairstyle in the middle part. So I'm gonna go ahead and part my hair. So as you all can see, I'm just going in with a rat tail comb to part my hair down the middle as evenly as possible. Alright guys, so once I have my hair parted nice and even in the middle, I'm going in with my flat iron to just get rid of any curliness, any type of texture that's not straight, because you want this style to be as smooth and sleek as possible. So now I'm going in with my Shine and Jam conditioning gel. You guys, this gel is the truth. It does not curl my hair up. It doesn't make it flaky or crusty. I love this gel. I'm just taking that and applying it all over my head. I'm also going in with my organic beeswax to really seal the deal, add some extra shininess, and really tame those flyaways. I'm using my medium to hard bristle brush to smooth everything out and make it nice and sleek. Once that is done, I'm going in with two scrunchies just for that extra security. You want your ponytail to be as tight as possible because once you start braiding, it can loosen up as you go. So just make sure that you're tying your hair extra tight. So this is what you want your base to look like. Nice, flat, smooth, and shiny. Going in with my braiding hair. This is by the company Sensational. It's in the color 1B. This is pre-stretched hair and it's in 24 inches. I really like this because I feel like it blends with my natural hair really well. So as you all can see here, I know I look crazy, but what I'm doing is I'm just brushing out my edges and baby hairs that I'm going to be using for this style, and I'm using the same medium to soft bristle brush that you all see me using earlier. Alright guys, so now I'm just taking my satin scarf that I got from Walmart and I'm folding that in half and I'm placing that on top of my base or foundation, whichever you want to call it, of my braided ponytail, and I'm tying that as tight as I possibly can to really seal the deal, make sure everything is nice and laid for when I take it off. So now I'm just just going in with my braiding hair. They did come separate, but I am going to be putting them together just for that extra fullness. I'm going to be attaching that to my ponytail by the two rubber bands that you all see here. And I'm just going to be tying that as tight as I can so that it can stay together. Once that's attached, I'm just going to put the braiding hair on top of my hair instead of underneath, because I feel like it just blends well and it's easier to braid that way. Now I'm just taking out a small piece of braiding hair because I am gonna need that for later. So now I'm just dividing my real hair along with the braiding hair into three somewhat equally sections so that I can begin the braiding process. As you all can see, I'm just starting my braiding process. Pro tip, when you're braiding your hair and using any kind of braiding hair, you want to make sure that you're detangling the braiding hair, because honey, once that hair is tangled, that's it. So just make sure that you're keeping that hair as detangled as possible. So when you start braiding your hair, you are going to notice that your real hair is sticking out, maybe towards like the ends. To combat that issue, you just go in with like any gel, jam, or grease and put that on the ends that are sticking out so that it can blend well and just be nice and smooth. As I got towards the end, I did notice that one piece of the braiding hair was uneven from all the rest. So when that happens, all you do is you just take hair from a piece that's more fuller and add to that piece to even it back out. Taking two rubber bands and I'm placing that at the end of the braid, and I'm using two because you just want it to just stay in place and not, you know, loosen up or anything like that. Guys, so the small piece of braiding hair that I took out from earlier is what I'm using now to wrap around the braids to cover up the scrunchies, the rubber bands, things of that nature. And I just feel like it adds a more cleaner, nicer touch to the look. And to secure that piece of hair that I wrapped around, I'm just using a bobby pin, but you can also use the Got to Be Free spray. After taking off my scarf, this is where things got a little ghetto. I didn't have a perm rod, so I had to take a highlighter and wrap around the end of my braid and secure it with a bobby pin so that I could give it a curl. So once that's secure, I'm just going to be taking some hot water and dipping that into the braid to give it that cute little curl at the end. Perfect, but it's something, so I'm just gonna try to finesse that, okay? Okay. All right. Alright guys, so moving on to the edges, I'm taking my Edge Booster by Style Factor. This is in the pineapple scent. It's an okay edge control. It does flake up. I'm using that with my two-sided edge brush. It has a comb part on one side and a brush on the other. I love this, you guys. I know I'm late, but this is like everything. Oh my gosh. So yeah, now we're just gonna be adding some flair to the baby hairs. Okay, girl, we're just gonna give it life. We're just gonna give this look the life that it deserves, you know? So yeah. Guys, so now for my sideburns, or whatever you want to call them, I'm just using my flat iron to curl them, because this really helps with giving it that nice perfect little curl swoop that you want. So guys, this is the final look. I'm trying to back up so you all can see. This is my braid. This is what the back looks like. And yeah, this is the final product. I hope you all like it. Let me know if you all want to see more content like this. I will definitely make it for y'all. Bye. La, la, la. Thanks for watching. Bye. Mwah.